This is the telecast of Emmanuel Temple Church, located at 1 Seneca Parkway in the heart of Rochester, New York, where our pastor is Elder Mike Lacey, and his wife is Dr. Sharisa Lacey, and we welcome you to worship in any of our services. Our weekly schedule is as follows. Daily, we have prayer from noon to 1, with the exception of Wednesdays, when prayer is from 11 to 12. Monday evenings, we have prayer from 7:15 to 8:15. On Wednesday afternoons, we have noonday Bible class from noon to 1. Wednesday evenings, we have prayer and teachers meeting at 7:30 p.m. At 8 p.m., our Bible class begins promptly at 8 p.m. On Thursdays, we have choir rehearsal for the Mass and also the youth choir beginning at 7 p.m. Every first and third Friday of each month is our youth ministry services. On Sunday, our Christian education classes begin at 9 a.m. and our Sunday morning worship begins at 2:45. On Sunday evening, at 10:45, I'm sorry. At Sunday evenings, our consecration services begin at 5 p.m. and our evening worship begins at 6 p.m. If you are in the city of Rochester and need a ride to any of our services, please call 490-2055. If you need to leave a message Monday through Friday, please leave it by 5 p.m. Please leave your name, your number, the number of passengers, and your address. On Saturdays, please leave it by 8 p.m. You can see our telecast on cable channel 98.5 or channel 15 on Sundays at 5 p.m. and on Wednesdays at 11:30 a.m. This is our 2017 Youth Search Services. So next you will hear New York, which is our youth choir. And then we have a guest speaker, Elder David Hollis out of Indiana. Amen.
The presence of the Lord is here.
Jesus at the center of it all. Jesus at the center of it all. From beginning to the end, it'll always be, it's always been you, Jesus. Jesus, everybody say,
Jesus at the center of it all. Jesus at the center of it all.
From beginning to the end.
From beginning to the end. It'll always be. It's always been you, Jesus. At the center of it all. Jesus at the center of it all.
From beginning to the
From
end.
Beginning to the end. It will always be. It's always been you, Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus. At the center of my life. Jesus at the center of my life. From beginning to the end, it will always be, it's always been you, Jesus. Jesus, be the center of your church. Every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess you, Jesus.
Power in the name of
Jesus.
To the heavens, Jesus be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about you.
From my heart to the heavens, Jesus be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about you. From my heart to the heavens, Jesus be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about you. From my heart to the heavens, Jesus be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about you. From my heart to the heavens, Jesus be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about you.
My heart is ready.
a blessing from you. 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 To worship you, I live. worship you. To worship you I live. To worship you I live. I live to worship you.
Your best praise. Give him your best praise because he's wonderful. Thank you, Jesus God. Give him your best praise because he's mighty.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus God. Give him your best praise.
Hallelujah.
Because he kept you another day. Thank you, Jesus God.
Okay, so I'm a gifter. I love to give gifts. That's just me. And dealing with this youth search and dealing with the kids and being a part of these kids' lives. And dealing with the kids, they become a part of your family. They become a part of your heart, and you just want the best for them. And the kids that come out of Emmanuel Temple, you can attest, are some great kids. They're very, very intelligent. They know the word of God, and they're, for the most part, very respectful kids. And I just thank God for them. And the Lord laid it on my heart last year to do the Youth of the Year. So before I do that, we have to honor our founder. This is our 28th annual youth search that was started by our First Lady, Dr. Dorothy Lacey, who laid a solid foundation. You're not supposed to wait till you get old to be saved. You're never too young. There's no age in the Bible where it says you have to wait till you get 25. It starts from actually the womb. So we just want to honor you today, Mother Lacey. I mean, you've poured so much of yourself. It seems like we drained you, but you've poured so much of yourself into each and every one of us, and we thank and praise God that you are actually still here with us today. You are at our youth search. God has answered prayers because we wanted you to come back home from Mississippi so bad. So we thank and praise God for you, and these flowers are for you.
Amen.
Okay, now, before we get to the youth of the year, we have our honorees. Now, the second runner up is one of our seniors, but we have a special presentation for them, so I'm gonna skip over that person. But it was Tori. Congratulations, Tori. And we have some special honorees because it's important to teach your children, and Bishop speaks of it a lot, to maintain where we are. This is our home, and we must treat this as our home, and we have to clean up after ourselves and do good diligence to this church. So we have some young men. It was one Sunday, a young man was asked to just help clean up, and he is the type of kid that does help whenever help is needed. He is a child that came up from having a speech impediment to being having an outstanding report card. He is a child that doesn't give you no problems, that got into a little trouble this year, but then the teacher begged and pleaded for forgiveness for him because that's what type of kid he is. He helps in school, he helps out of school, and he's just an all-around great kid, no problems with him. So we're gonna honor Kyron Jesse today. Gift card. And he's baptized, and he can't wait to go to TM camp next year. So it was a lot to clean up downstairs, and what happened was it was another young man that hung around. So Kyron was like, "You want to help?" And he said, "Well, yeah." So we want to honor, just for being a good helper as well, KJ. A bit of cash, you know what I'm saying? You can use that. Okay, so now, youth of the year. Woo! What could I say? This youth of the year, watching this beautiful young person grow is amazing. Baptized and filled with the Holy Ghost at the age of 10. It's just an awesome thing. I mean, have maintained high honor roll, have helped everybody wherever she can. She was just promoted to, what is it called? What is she called? The choir director, junior choir director. second assistant to the choir director. Not only that, but she was the TM camper of the year. For the ninth grade, and just for being an all-around outstanding, awesome young lady and a dynamic, boisterous singer. We thank you, we bless you, and I'm so proud to call her my younger cousin. This year, I do give a plaque. The plaque is not here. I do apologize. You will have it by next week, hopefully. But I do have you a gift card. This year's, everybody stand up and give honor to Miss Autumn Kimora Flowers, Youth of the Year 2017. Next week we'll have her plaque and I'll show you guys her plaque, but Autumn, say something.
Me?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. No, I said praise the Lord.
For he is worthy.
Yes. I'm a little speechless right now. First, I want to give thanks to Bishop and Mother Lacey. Also, I want to give thanks to Elder Hollis for coming here and giving us this great word. A special thank you out to my parents for always encouraging me, and to all the other like young people, because we always encourage each other and give each other the right words to say, and just always try to, how to grow together in a way. And a special thank you to all the staffs, especially Sister Pam, because she does so much. There was times when on Saturday mornings I'll go over her house and we're just like planning all the songs and all we're gonna, I'm talking about early in the morning, and we're just planning everything. And I wanna thank her for everything that she does and her encouragement. I wanna thank you, Sister Megan and Sister Ivy, for always doing the great things that you guys do and always cooking and stuff.
Amen. So,
yeah.
Thank you for all who voted. This is gonna be a big thing. We're gonna continue to do this because it's a big thing for us to encourage our young people, you know? So we gotta find ways to keep them in the church, keep them active in the church, and keep church interesting for them. Make them see that God is the only way, amen? All right, two more gifts. So my next gift is to the man of God that came and blessed us this weekend, all the way from Indiana. He blessed us last year. He is like a big on request here at Emmanuel Temple and probably all around the world. But we thank him for being so dedicated to the word of God. We thank him for always blessing us no matter what and allowing us to be on his schedule. Thank you for being so personable and even just... the young people even love you. Thank you for even just some people you can't talk to, you know. He mingles with the young people. You know what I mean? The young people love him just as much as the adults love him. So, and that's very important. That's very important. So we thank Elder Hollis. Me and Pam and Neil was in Paris. And we was in the marketplace, right? And we saw this little boutique. And I'm like, yeah, let's go in here, right? So this is from Perry. And this is for you, Elder Hollis.
Bishop and Mother Lacey, and to all of the saints of ET, and to the young people, I say thank you very much. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Last one for me while falling is crack. This person, I wish we would have become friends a long, long time ago, but I just blessed the Lord that he allowed us to come together right on time. And there's just not enough for me to ever give or not enough for me to ever say, because she gives so much of herself all the time. I've never seen a person run like her. I've never seen a person travel off of 2 hours of sleep, give. We don't ask for receipts when we buy stuff. I'm not boasting or anything like that. We give because God gives to and blesses us. We don't ask for nothing back, and she never asks for nothing back. And she gives and gives and gives and gives. So I want to bless the Lord for my friend, my true friend in the word. I you know how I asked the Lord for a friend that is saved? Because you have friends that are not saved, but I asked the Lord for a friend that was saved and knew the word that could help me. And I thank God for her, because she keep me going. And whatever she need, I don't care what time it is, I got her. I got her, because I got these young people and God got me. So today I want to honor with all my heart, Pam.
Girl got me crying, right? It's a mess. And plus, like, I already sweat my face and I get subconscious, because when I was a little girl, my dad I sweat on my nose. So my daddy used to tell me when I was little, mean people sweat on their nose. He used to always think I was mean. But I truly think and praise God. For she said, I know you like coffee, so she gave me this, and this is my favorite chocolate. And then she said, and I know you bougie, so I gave you a bougie basket. I truly, truly, truly thank and praise God for my team. Brother Taryn is a hard worker. He takes care of his family. He's my vice president. I've been there, especially when you work in the IT field or when you in the warehouse. He's over. When you got to be at work, you got to be at work. But I thank and praise God for Sister Megan. I remember when I went to the bishop, I said, I need to appoint somebody. I wanted to see if it was okay to appoint a second vice president. And Bishop, we was downstairs, Bishop said, well, go on and ask her. I didn't say who it was, but he already knew, and that was confirmation. She really does. She comes through in the clutch. Her and Sister Tequila, we be here early. We stay late. And she tell me all the time, she's like, you are not leaving me anymore. Wherever you go, I'm going. I told her about TM Camp, so her and all her kids coming next year. And I thank, praise God for it, but it really is a labor of love. The Lord called me and saved me when I was 19, and I didn't come from a church background. And what I do for these young people, somebody did it for me. So I saw that, and I just went on. And as the Lord appointed me to do what was necessary, that's what I do. I don't believe in gimmicks. I don't believe in a whole bunch of other things. All I believe is the Word of God. And the Bible, I'll never see what a gimmick pull people in. It was always the Word of God.
worship you. You are here working in this place. I worship you. I worship you. You are here moving in our midst. I worship you. I worship you. You are here working in this place. I worship you. I worship you. Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are a way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. I worship you, I worship you. You are here moving in our midst. I worship you, I worship you. Hey, way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You wipe away all tears, you mend the broken heart. You're the answer to it all, Jesus. You wipe away our tears, you mend the broken heart. You're the answer to it all, to it all, Jesus. Hey! Waymaker, miracle worker, my way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are my way. Miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are here moving in our midst. I worship you, I worship you. You are here worship you, I worship you. You are here working in this place. I worship you, I worship you.
Yeah.
Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good.
That's right.
And his mercy endureth forever. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord of Lords, for he is good, and his mercy endureth forever. It is amazing to me that we soon forget what the Lord has done. We soon forget the way he's made. We soon forget how low he had to reach to bring us up out of that horrible pit. But let us not be an unthankful people. Let us always remember, had it not been for the Lord who was on our side, where would we be? Somebody give the Lord a great hand praise. I was listening to the song that they were singing. He's a waymaker,
yes.
Miracle worker,
yes.
Promise keeper,
yes.
Light in the darkness.
Yes.
My God, that's who you are.
Amen.
I want you to repeat those words. Say waymaker,
miracle worker,
promise keeper.
Light in the darkness.
Tell God that's who you are.
Amen.
Somebody say waymaker,
miracle worker,
promise keeper. Light in the darkness. My God, that's who you are. Come on, lift your voice and just sing that. Tell God he's a waymaker. Promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You know the words, sing it. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You're singing it unto the Lord. Tell him he's a waymaker. Check your history. If you know him to be a waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that's who you are. Look over your life, and if he's been a waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that's who you are. You can only sing it if you've got history with God. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God. One more time, lift your voice and say, waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God. That's who you are. Somebody give the Lord the best hand clap you can. Oh. Oh. One more time, shout waymaker. Promise keeper. Light in the darkness. My God. If you believe that he is, sing it with all you got. Don't sing to your neighbor, sing to the Lord. Waymaker.
Church of the Living God. The God that we serve, He's a promise keeper. He's light in the darkness. Anybody know Him to be a waymaker? Anybody know Him to be a miracle worker? Anybody know Him to make you a promise and keep that promise? The God that we serve is a waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. That is who You are. Oh, hallelujah. For the God that we serve, He's a strong tower. He's a mighty fortress. He is our bulwark. He is our shield and our buckler. The Bible says He is a buckler. He is a shield to them that trust in Him. Oh, hallelujah. And for that, we're thankful to the Lord. Thankful to God that He's allowed us to see the beginning of another week. Whatever happened last week is gone. Thank God for a new week. Somebody say amen. Amen. I want to salute and give God praise for Bishop and Mother Lacey. We're very thankful to God for the both of them being in the house of the Lord. I want to salute and give God praise for Elder Lacey and Elder Singletary. We salute you both in the name of the Lord. Thankful to God for the youth staff and all those that work on the youth staff. I appreciate them. Thank you, Sister Pam. Thank you, Sister Ivy, Sister Megan. Thank you all. I appreciate each one of you, and I'm grateful to the Lord for your kindness that you've shown to me. Thank you for my bow tie from Petty. I appreciate that. Thank you. It will be worn. There's some gifts people give you, and sometimes you look at them and you say, oh, thank you. And some people say, oh, you shouldn't have. And they really mean you shouldn't have. But I thank you because you did. I appreciate that. And we're very thankful to what the Lord has done this week. To Deacon Strickland and Brother Paris, I want to thank them for their hospitality and their kindness to me. I am very grateful to God for what the Lord is doing in the midst of His people, and thankful to God for being at Emmanuel Temple. Deacon Vincent, it's good to see you in the house of the Lord. The Lord is gracious, and thank you for your service in the house of God. To the music ministry, outstanding music ministry today, singing and giving praises unto God. Let's go to the word of the Lord. It's in Psalm 73. Psalm 73. If you wouldn't mind rising to your feet for the hearing and the reading of the word of the Lord. Teach your children to stand. They follow your example. Psalm 73, beginning at the first, and I'll instruct you further. Truly, God is good to Israel, even to such as are of a clean heart. But as for me, my feet were almost gone, my steps had well nigh slipped. For I was envious at the foolish when I saw the prosperity of the wicked. Verse number 12. Behold, these are the ungodly who prosper in the world. They increase in riches. Verily, I have cleansed my heart in vain and washed my hands in innocency. For all the day long have I been plagued and chastened every morning. If I say, I will speak thus, behold, I should offend against the generation of thy children. When I thought to know this, it was too painful for me until I went into the sanctuary of God. Then understood I therein. When I thought to know this, it was too painful for me until I went into the sanctuary of God. Then understood I therein. Father, we've read the scriptures, now open them up to us. Save somebody, fill somebody with the Holy Ghost. Baptize somebody in water in the name of Jesus. Anoint me afresh. Let your word go out and it will not return to you void, but it will prosper in the thing that you sent it to. We trust it to do so. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. When I thought to know this, it was too painful for me until I went into the sanctuary of God. Then understood I therein. For a few moments, out of the word of the Lord, I'd like to minister to you from this subject. Let's go to church.
All right.
Help me preach. Tell somebody, let's go to church. The word of the Lord is ministered this morning out of a book that we refer to as the Book of Psalms. By definition, the term psalm means holy writings. It means sacred song. There are several words that are used in the Hebrew for the term psalm. 13 of them are referred to as shir. Everybody say shir. Don't be afraid of it. Say shir. It means flow of speech, sacred song, flow of speech. There are 58 times you will see the word psalm translated as the word mitzmor. Everybody say mitzmor. I'll wait on everybody. Everybody say mitzmor. The term mitzmor, it means a lyrical ode. It is a lyrical ode. It is a song. It's a lyrical ode. It is a flow of speech. We don't use the term flow of speech. Today, we have different vernacular, but it is a cadence. It is words put to a beat, words put to music. It is a strong cadence, a rhythmic pattern of speech. It is the psalm that has this sacred speech. The Sefer Tehillim refers to it as the book of praise. It is a song or words with history to it, words that speak from the heart, words that music has been applied to express your relationship or your experience, particularly here with God. Sometimes when the preacher is preaching and he says, the psalmist said, we immediately think that David wrote all the psalms. But David is not the writer of all the psalms. Though there are 150 psalms, David writes 73 of them. But there are other writers of the psalm. We learn in the scripture that Moses writes psalm. Solomon writes psalm. Korah writes psalm. Heman writes psalm. Even Ethan writes psalm. But when we arrive at the 73rd psalm, it is a writer by the name of Asaph. Now, several sometimes in certain circles, you will hear people say, turn with me to the 54th division of Saul. Yeah. Sometimes you'll hear people say, turn with me to the 100th division of Saul. Technically, they are incorrect, because the psalm only had five divisions. It is broken up into five books, just like the Pentateuch or the Torah. Remember, Moses is the writer of the Torah, the writer of the Pentateuch. The term penta is the word that we get the English word from, pint, which means fifth. So the Pentateuch is the volume of five, the five first five books of the Bible: Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. Well, the psalm is broken up into five books as well. The first five, or the first division, is Psalm 1 to Psalm 41. That's considered book one. Psalm 42 to Psalm 72 is considered book two. Psalm 73 to Psalm 89 is considered book three. Psalm 90 to Psalm 106 is considered book four. Psalm 107 to Psalm 150 is considered book five. So when we arrive at Psalm 73, Psalm 73 is the beginning of book three. Psalm 73 to Psalm 89 is the third division of the five that we refer to as the division of Saul. When we arrive at 73, it is the writings of a gentleman by the name of Asaph. His name means gatherer. The name Asaph means corral, to corral, or to gather, to bring together, almost in the form of a choir. Sometimes you've heard singing groups called the Gospel Chorale. You've heard singing groups called the New York Chorale. Well, the name Asaph means to corral, or to gather together. Asaph was a celebrated musician, but he was not just simply a musician. He was a seer as well as a musician. Asaph could not only play, he could sing, but he also had the gift to be able to see. He had discernment. He had the ability to see into the future. He had the ability to have insight into the workings of God. His name is put at the beginning. It is the prefix of at least 12 Psalms. He is a leader not only in singing, but he's also a poet. So Asaph could write music. He could write lyrics. He could score music, and then he could turn around and sing what he wrote. Now, that is important, because everybody that can write lyrics can't sing. Some people can sing, but they can't play. And you have to know your gift. Just because you wrote the song don't mean you have to be the one to sing the song. If the Bible had been written in the 21st century, there probably would have been a scripture called stay in your lane. That's what you have to learn to do. You operate in the gift that God has given you. If God's given you the gift to write, if you are a poet, you write. If God's given you the gift that you can score music, you score music. If God's given you the ability to sing what you wrote, then you sing what you wrote. But if you can only write, stick to writing. If you can only play, some musicians can play, but they can't sing. thing. We just need you to do what God has called you to do. Well, it is this guy ASAP. He could sing, he could write, he could score. Not only could he sing, write, and score, but he had gifting of discernment. It is this writing that he writes. Some say he scored this. Some say this was something that he wrote. Some say this is what he sang. He sang it, maybe he didn't write it. What we know from the text is that it is a writing of ASAP. We know he wrote it. Maybe he wrote it in a key for somebody else to sing, or whether he sang it himself. When he starts, he says, truly God is good to Israel. He makes a universal statement. His opening verse, the opening verse of this song, the opening chorus, the first line of this song says, God is good to Israel. He makes this universal statement. It is a national statement. All around the country, everybody can sing, truly, God has been good to this nation. But then he brings it a little closer. He takes it from being this national statement and he makes it a little more closer to home. He says, not only is God good to Israel, but then he says, God is also good to those that are of a clean heart. He starts bringing it a little more. He starts honing it in and narrowing it down. He takes it from a national statement that God is good to everybody. Then he brings it a little closer. But not only is God good to everybody, but he's really good to those that are of a clean heart. But then his next statement baffles me, because he says God is good to everybody. Truly God is good to Israel. Then he says God is good to those that are of a clean heart. But then he says, but as for me. He starts making the song personal. God is good to the nation. God is good to those that are of a clean heart. But then he makes it personal and says, but as for me. He says, my foot was well nigh slipped. He says, my foot rather was almost gone. My step had well nigh slipped. ASAP, wait a minute. What's wrong, ASAP? How could God be good to the nation? How could God be good to those that are of a clean heart? But when it got to you personally, my foot was almost gone. My step had well nigh slipped. When he uses this term, foot and step, he's not speaking that he tripped over something. He's not saying that he was walking down the stairs and his foot slipped off the step. But rather, he's talking about his relationship with God. He said, in my walk, I start tripping. He said, I know God was good to the nation. And I know God is good to those that are of a clean heart. But as for me, I start tripping. How could you trip with a good God? How could you start acting a fool when God's been good to you? How could you start clowning after the goodness of God has been seen in the nation, has been seen in your community, but now you're tripping and you're walking with God is staggering? How does a man end up tripping with God?
He starts telling you, he says, this is how it happened. He said, I start looking at the prosperity of the wicked. He says, I start looking at the, he said, I start becoming envious of the wicked. He didn't say I was jealous. There's a difference between jealousy and envy. You see, jealousy says, I like that suit, Brother Vincent, and I want a suit like it. Jealousy says, Elder Singletary, I like that watch, and I want a watch just like it. Jealousy says, Bishop, I like them shoes, and I want shoes just like it. That's jealousy. But envy is different. Envy says, I like that suit, Brother Vincent, and I don't want a suit like it. I want that suit. Envy says, I don't want to watch Elder Singletary like that. I want that watch. Envy says, Bishop, I don't want some shoes like those shoes. I want those shoes. You see, jealous single people look at married people and they say, they got a wife. I want a wife. But envious single people look at married people and say, they got a wife. I want their wife. Jealous single people say, they got a husband. Why can't I have a husband? But envious single people say, they got a husband. I want their husband. He didn't say I was jealous at the wicked. He said I was envious at the wicked. I wanted what the wicked people had. I knew they stole it, but I wanted it anyway. I knew they got it off a truck and it was hot, but I wanted it anyway. I knew they scratched off the serial numbers, but I wanted it anyway. He said, I looked at them because they didn't go to church. He said, every worship time, I got my whole family and we going to church. He said, and while we going to church, I look at them. They outside watering their lawn. He said, here I am struggling. I'm struggling trying to make ends meet. I give offering and pay tithe. And the devil's still fighting my finances. He said, but I looked at the wicked. He played a lottery. He hit four box and square. He say, I am serving the Lord. And he go to the casino. I go to church for 3 hours. He go to the casino for 5 hours. I give offering in church. He leave the casino. Cashing in chips and coins. He said, and it looks like his family is always together. But the devil fighting my family. Here I am serving the Lord. And the devil try to come up in this house and take my child. His child don't go to church. And they graduate magna cum laude. His child don't go to church. And they get scholarships off to school. He said, and it bothered me. He said, this thing wrapped my brain. He said, the more I thought about it, it was painful for me. He said, because it didn't make sense that after all I give to God, I still have to shed some tears. After all I do for God, I feel like I'm still struggling. And when I look at the wicked person that lied to get everything he got, when I look at the wicked person, here I am speaking the truth, and they didn't give me the job because I told the truth on my application, but he lied on his application. They knew he was lying and he still got the job. Here I am serving the Lord, God, and they won't promote me. But he cussed, lied, and fussed, and they gave him the raise and the promotion. He said it was painful for me. It hurt my head. He said, and I couldn't figure it out. He said, but when I went to the sanctuary of God, he said, I found something in the sanctuary that the wicked man don't have. He said, when I came in the sanctuary, I found peace in my soul. When I came in the sanctuary, I might have come with a heavy heart, but I could cast all my care on him, because he careth for me. When I walked in church, I entered his gates with thanksgiving, and I stepped in his courts with praise. I've got a father. Church, do you understand that when God filled you with the Holy Ghost, somewhere in there you cried Abba? It meant Father. Why is that so important? Because there was a time I couldn't call God my father, because I was a child of the devil. I was born in sin and shapen in iniquity. I was the seed of darkness, but thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory. Now that I've been born of the incorruptible seed, which is the word of God, I've been baptized in his name and filled with his spirit, I now can look up and say, our Father, which art in heaven. The wicked man don't have that privilege. I can come boldly to the throne of grace. The wicked man don't have that privilege. When I'm sick, he's the healer of my body. The wicked man don't have that privilege. When I'm sad, he's the lifter of my head. The wicked man don't have that privilege. I almost slipped. I almost messed up when I was focused on the wicked. But when I turned my focus back to the God of the sanctuary, I understood that I'm in the best place. I'm in the place where I can find strength. I go from strength to strength in Zion. Everybody has trouble. The saint get cancer and the sinner get cancer. The saint get diabetes and the sinner get diabetes. The saint get trouble and the sinner get trouble. But when the sinner get trouble, he got to go to the weed to escape. He got to go to the gin to escape. He got to go to the needle and escape. But when my heart is overwhelmed, I go to the rock. I can cast my care, and I ain't got to get drunk. I get deliverance, and I ain't got to get high. I can leave church, and I don't smell like weed, but I've been delivered. It's when I went to church. Do me a favor. Grab somebody and say, I need you to say it like a preacher. Say, I don't care what you're going through. Let's go to church. You might have tears in your eyes, but let's go to church. You might not feel well in your body, but let's go to church. You might have some troubles you're facing, but let's go to church. Because when you get there, Jesus will be there. When you get there, angels will be there. When you get there, the songs of Zion will be there. When you get there,
you won't leave the same way you came. You go to the club. You're not guaranteed a good time. You go to the club. Somebody you meet in the club. When you get her home, she ain't who you thought he was. When you get to the club, they might not play your song.
All right.
When you get to the club, somebody might drop something in your drink. And you might not make it back home. But oh, when you come to the house of God, joy unspeakable and full of glory. When you come to the house of God, He's your joy, He's your strength, He's your peace, and He's the lover of your soul. And the good thing that I love about Him, when I take Him home, I ain't got no surprises. He was good to me in church. He'll be good to me when I get home. He gets sweeter and sweeter as the days go by. Oh, what a love between my Lord and I. I keep falling in love with Him. Over and over and over. This relationship don't get stale. This relationship don't get boring. This relationship don't dry up. He's a river of living water. Saints of God, stop making excuses. I don't care what you see in the world. Let's go to church.
Let's go to church.
Let's go to church.
Hallelujah.
Get your kids up and say, let's go to church.
Hallelujah.
Wake your spouse up and say, we going to church.
Hallelujah.
You can go to the game, you can go to church.
Hallelujah. Say that.
Some of y'all use your sickness as an excuse. You go everywhere else.
Say that.
But then when it's time for church, I don't feel like going out tonight. But you've been out all day.
All right now.
Well, I'ma just stretch out at home, but I don't want to sit in church that long. But you got a doctor's appointment tomorrow at 1:15. And the doctor not gonna see you till 3:15. So you gonna sit there for 2 hours in a hard chair in the lobby. But you couldn't sit in God's presence for 2 hours? Only gonna see you for 15 minutes and he gonna give you some more medication to make you drowsy. You could have sat here for 2 hours in God's presence and went home healed by the power of God. Let's go to church. Let's go to church. Let's go to church. Let's go to church. Get it in your spirit. Let's go to church. Get it in your mind. Let's go to church. Tell your children, we going to church. Putamaya. Do you know this place is so effective?
Thank you, Jesus.
That as a baby, your parents brought you here.
Yeah, amen.
You were blessed at church.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
This place is so effective. But when a man meets a woman and he's ready to change her name to his name, he brings her to the church altar. This place is so effective that when you hear the gospel and it pricks your heart, when you repent, the gospel was preached here at church. You came down to the altar at church. We baptized you in water at church. You got the Holy Ghost at church. This place is so effective that even when you die, before we take you to the cemetery and put you in the heart of the earth, the last place we bring you is back to the church.
Hallelujah. Amen. Amen.
Saints of God, stop devaluing this place.
Yes. Hallelujah. Amen.
This ain't some other auditorium.
Right.
This ain't no arena. Stop letting your kids run through here and play. This ain't no game. Foolishness is bound in the heart of a child, so I don't blame the child.
All right.
I blame the parents. We used to try to run in church too. My grandmother would snatch us. She said, come here, boy, I'll snatch a knot in you. She said, if you don't sit down, I'm gonna turn you every which way but loose. And one of her favorite scriptures to us when we were kids, she said, the Bible say, keep your feet when you come in the house of God. When no such thing is, I gotta go to the bathroom. No, no, no. You went to bathroom before church started.
All right.
I don't have to go. She say, try. And it was amazing. Every time we tried, we did. She said, try. Why? She used to tell us, you're not gonna make me miss a move of God. She said, I don't want to be downstairs in the bathroom with you and God moving upstairs.
Hallelujah. Amen, amen.
Church, some of your children play you. They smarter than you think they are. They know you so well.
All right now.
Some of your children, when you threaten them, they say, oh, she ain't gonna do nothing.
That's the truth.
Oh, she ain't gonna do nothing. Teach your children, this is the house of God. Stop coming to church late just to be late.
Amen, amen.
Well, I ain't gonna get there early because they ain't gonna start on time. Well, we got a few more minutes because right about now they just take an offering.
All right.
All the plan. The praise team is still up. They're going to be up for 30 minutes. So we I don't see you doing that on your job.
I know that's right. All right.
I don't see you telling your job, well, it's about lunchtime, so I guess I'll go to work. This place is more effective to your soul. What this place gives you, money can't buy.
Yes. Hallelujah. Right. Amen.
The consolation of the word of God and the power of the Holy Ghost, money cannot buy. Saints of God, let's go to church.
Let's go to church.
Stop just throwing on something. I, well, it's just church. Some of y'all treat the club better than you do the house of God. You throw on anything to come here, but you get fixed up to go out at night. The devil is a liar.
Amen.
Get yourself together. Let's go to church. So what? You had a bad week. That's the best time to come to church.
Yes, it is.
You had a fantastic week. That's the best time to come to church. You got a lot of things going on. That's the best time to come to church. Things going real well. That's the best time to come to church. Because every time to come to church, it's the best time to come.
That's right. Amen.
It's in this place that you consider not only your past, but your future.
Yes.
It's in this place that the truth is spoken to you. And you have to acknowledge truth. People out there lie to you. You know you look 93. And they lying to you, and you talk about, for real. You saw the same mirror every morning. Stop letting the lies flatter you. You don't believe me? The scripture says it this way: a lying lip and a flattering tongue, God will cut off. After a while, the lying lip, it's going to be shut down. The flattering tongue is going to be sewed up.
All right.
And you're going to have to live with the truth.
Yes.
Deal with the truth now. Hallelujah. The truth will set you, not only set you, but the truth will make you free. You shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Stuff that's set free could get bound again. But when you've been made free, Lord, have mercy. Saints of God, do me a favor. Find three people around you and tell them, let's go to church, let's go to church, let's go to church, let's go to church, let's go to church. Let's go to church. All y'all that like to post stuff on social media, post that. Let's go to church. Hashtag let's go to church. Hashtag let's go to church. Hashtag let's go to church. If they can say everything else on the internet, surely you can say, let's go to church. What am I? Go! We are a bettered people because we've come to the house of God. We are an enriched people. We are an enlightened people. We are grown people. We are matured people. Because we went to church. Father, I thank you in the name of Jesus Christ for your word. Thank you for the writings of Asaph, because we saw that not only are you good to a nation and not only are you good to a community, but once we take closer looks, you've also been good to us. Thank you, Lord. That even with all the issues and calamities we might experience in life, such as is common to man, you reign on the just and the unjust. Sickness is in the land, but you're our healer. Disease is in the land, but you rebuke it for our sake. Violence is in the land, but you're our protector. Hallelujah. God, we don't take these things for granted. It's in the house of God. It's in the presence of the Lord. In his presence is the fullness of joy. And at his right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. Lord, let us be more conscious of the sanctuary of God. Let us be more aware that you put your name here and your spirit is here. And when we can't find you any other place, we can find you in your own house. Holiness becometh your house. Your house shall be called the house of prayer to all nations. We thank you for it. In Jesus' name, amen. Everybody that heard the scripture speak to you today, give God the best hand clap you can. I want to salute all of you that had the fight and you won. Because for some of you, your beds fought with you this morning. Your covers fought with you. Your Stearns and Foster and your Sealy Posturepedic told you lay down 20 more minutes.
I know that's right.
But you rebuked them covers and you went to church. I salute you for winning that fight this morning. But I encourage you for the rest of the year, win that battle. Be an overcomer. Be more than a conqueror. Strive for the things that make for peace. Follow peace with all men, and holiness without which no man shall see the Lord. Tonight, since you're in God's house, right now, since you're in his presence on holy ground, and there are angels all around. The Bible refers to angels as ministering spirits. They do the service and the bidding of God. Many times while we're in service, while we're worshiping, God sends angels to minister to us. Many times while we're in prayer, angels come to strengthen us. The Holy Spirit is in you making intercession. Oh, with groanings which cannot be uttered. Do you know God is working not only outside but inside for you? That's why we sing that song, he's on the right, on the left, in front and back, underneath, over me, and he's living, he's all over me. Because we're on holy ground. Tonight, if anybody's not saved, right now, it's time for you to make a decision to get your life right with God. Right now is the time for you to say yes to the will of God for your life. Stop laying in your bed, looking up in the ceiling and tears running into your ears, and you keep telling God, I want a better life.